In the last video, you learned how to set your expectations and prepare your mindset for success. Now we're going to go over exactly what skills you need to learn so you can be as efficient as possible. For example, if your goal is to learn how to play chess so that you can play with your 10-year-old, you're not going to go and study the Grandmaster Preparation Series, right? Same thing goes for iOS app development. The problem is that sometimes it can be hard to tell what you need to know and what you don't need to know, especially as a beginner. So let me lay out a learning roadmap for you depending on your goal. Now, obviously I can't read your mind, but in my 10 years of teaching iOS app development, most people's goals have fallen into these two categories. You want to become an iOS developer so that you can find a job in the field, or you want to become an iOS developer so that you can build your own apps and make money. For simplicity, let's call this path professional and this path indie, and they have different required skills and learning paths. Just to go over a few more goals that I've heard, you want to build apps as a hobby, you want to build an app for your business, or you want to build an app for work. For these options, they're similar to the indie path, so let's put them there. Between the professional and indie paths, there are three main differences: the required technical skills, teamwork, and tools. Okay, let's start with the required technical skills. As a professional iOS developer, the required technical skills are different from that of the indie path because you'll be most likely working in a team environment at the workplace. Now, I know that's not always true because there's a chance you might be hired as the only iOS developer in the company, but I wouldn't recommend a job like that as your first iOS job. We'll talk about that later in this series when we get to the point of applying to jobs. For now, let's say that you're joining an established developer team as a junior iOS developer. Imagine a soccer or football team. There are different positions. You train for a specific position and you get hired for that position. Now, you can rely on your other teammates for the other positions, and your team also counts on you to be good at your own position. When it comes to apps, there are a few positions to play: product manager, designer, mobile developer, backend developer, tester, data scientist, and marketer. But because you're on a team, your role will be as an iOS developer. And if you're curious about what the other roles do, we're going to talk about that later in this video. So here are the basic skills that you need to know as an iOS developer. At the most basic level, you need to know how to use Xcode, how to write Swift code, how to build user interfaces, and how to debug and troubleshoot your code. Going up from that, at the intermediate level, you should understand concurrency in iOS, how to save data locally with core data, and experience with various Apple and third-party frameworks. Next, you need to know how to write test cases and do unit testing, and finally, deployment. Now, moving up from that, at the advanced level, you should know your software design patterns and your algorithms. You should know how to measure performance of algorithms using big O notation and how to measure the performance of your apps using Xcode instruments. Now, all of these skills at the advanced level is related to writing great code instead of just code that works. And just as a caveat, there are some additional skills for teamwork, just in case you're wondering, but that's going to be revealed later in this video. So that's roughly what you need to know as a professional iOS developer. But don't get me wrong, every day on the job, you will be learning new techniques and new skills and also making mistakes and learning from those mistakes. It's just part of the job. As a developer, the learning never stops. Next, let's take a look at some of the skills that you need if you're going to be building apps yourself. Now let's take a look at this football team diagram again. As a solo developer, you're going to be doing all of it. Wait. Don't panic, the scale of the app that you can build is actually much smaller. And that means although you need to learn skills in multiple areas, you only need to scratch the surface in each area. And these days, you can find a YouTube video to learn almost anything. Let's expand these roles a little bit and see what they do. As a product manager, since it's your own product, you'll have to figure out what type of app you want to build and what features you want to add. Learn some market research skills to find a need for your app. The other thing you have to do yourself is to manage the project. Learn how to set your own deadlines and to keep yourself accountable. It's easier than it sounds, especially when you don't have a boss. As a designer, you either roll your own design to the best of your abilities, you pick up some design skills, or you can pay someone else for the design work. The good thing is that Apple has human interface guidelines that outline best practices for design and usability. If you follow that, you'll be in pretty good shape. As a mobile developer, the technical skills we covered on the professional side still largely applies here, but you only need to know what pertains to your own app idea. For example, if your app doesn't use core data, just don't learn it. Also, the level 3 advanced skills won't be as important if your app is small. The impact of bad performing code won't be as noticeable here. As a backend developer, if your app requires a backend or database, you'll have to find out how to do that. But luckily, there are tools that we can leverage such as Firebase, which helps out in this regard. As a quality assurance tester on a small app, you might be able to get away with just informally testing your app, but it'll still be helpful to learn how to write test cases and to do unit testing. As a data scientist, since it's your own product, you'll have to analyze your data, draw conclusions, from it and decide what to do next. And then finally, as a marketer, you'll have to learn how to market your own app and to do app store optimization. Now, it seems like a lot to learn, but as an indie app developer, you get to learn the process from start to finish, and you get to reap all the rewards because it's your own app. And best of all, if your app gains traction and you build a user base, you can also consider selling the app. Keep in mind that your first app may not be a success, but I bet your 10th app will see some money. The other thing to consider is that although you have to learn all of these extra skills, you don't need to go through the job application process and interview process. So to sum it up, a professional goes deep into the technical skills. You have to be really good at what you do, and you have to rely on your other teammates for the other roles. And as an indie developer, you go wide instead, and you have to cover all the bases, all of the different roles, but you don't have to go as deep into each of them. Let's move on to the next set of skills required, teamwork. In a professional environment, there's a lot of teamwork and formality required. You need to know how to work together with other developers and other departments, such as interacting with design and quality assurance, being good at communication, raising flags, and setting expectations with your team members, which leads to being a team player. You know, documenting your code so that other people can follow what you're writing, following a style guide so that the code is consistent across the project. And then also a less talked about skill is being humble, you know, being open to feedback and criticism, and also asking for help when you need it. These soft skills are hard to learn on your own without actually doing it, so you'll just have to practice on the job once you get hired. As an indie, there's not much requirement for teamwork since you'll be doing everything yourself. Out of this list, I'd say that as an indie, it's still important to document your code properly and to maintain a consistent coding style across your project, and to learn how to work with a designer if you're going to be outsourcing that function. Let's move on to the third set of skills, tools. As a professional, there are a lot of industry standard tools and processes that you'll need to learn. Things such as source control, using it to branch and merge code, resolving code conflicts between team members, and also continuous integration and deployment. Those are the two big things that come into mind. As an indie, you can use whatever tools that you want. Here are some that might be useful to you. GitHub for source control, Figma for design, Firebase platform for backend and analytics features, Bitrise for continuous integration, RevenueCat for monetization, AppFollow for marketing research, Trello for project management, and Proxyman to debug web traffic. Ultimately, regardless of which path, professional or indie, tools are not that important because they're very easy to pick up and to learn. We've covered a lot in this video, so I had to create a map of the required skills for the two paths. You can download this as a PDF. The link is under the video. I've also starred the skills that I think are crucial for success. Now that you know which skills you need to learn depending on your goal, the next step is to find the learning resources to acquire these skills. That is in step 3 in the next video. If you haven't already, make sure you're subscribed to the channel so you don't miss it. And in the meantime, I want you to comment below and let me know, what is your goal for learning iOS app development? Is it to break into the industry and find a job, or is it to build your own apps? All right, thanks for watching. Don't forget to leave the comment. I'll see you in the next video.